Step 1. Measure and layout. Measure the floor surface adjacent to the structure and mark the center point on the floor and wall. Extend the line of the wall surface point onto the structure vertically. Determine the proper hanging rail height. Reference the diagram in the included installation guide for measurements specific to your kit. Step 2. Base cap expander installation. Locate and identify the appropriate pre-mitered base cap expander. Apply a line of butyl tape the length of the base cap expander. Starting at the wall, lay out the base cap expander along the approved foundation lines. Attach the base cap expander to the foundation with the approved fasteners adhering to the designated engineering specifications. Apply a bead of caulk at the butt and miter joints between the adjacent pieces of base cap expander. Step 3. Vertical installed female channel. Measure and mark the proper locations for the female wall channel attachments. Properly identify the female channel designated for the structure attachment locations. The female channel is symmetrical in construction and therefore does not have a specific interior or exterior face. Apply a line of butyl tape the length of the two vertical female channels. Prior to pressing the female wall attachment channel in place, confirm level. Press the female channel into place and finish securing it to the structure with the approved fasteners at the designated engineering spacing requirements. Repeat the installation process for the second vertical female channel. Step 4. Caulk. Be sure to apply a bead of caulk at all intersections between the vertically installed female wall channels and the existing structure. Apply a bead of caulk to the base of the female channel at its intersection with the base cap expander. Finally, caulk all of the base cap expander fastener locations. Step 5. Wall panel preparation. Using the exploded assembly diagram and bill of materials as a reference, unpack and separate the wall panels according to their corresponding labels. Once the wall section has been confirmed, prepare each wall panel for installation by removing the window sashes and screen. Remove the aluminum-framed pre-installed window screen prior to the removal of the window sashes. Carefully set all of the screens safely off to the side for later reinstallation. Next, remove the aluminum-framed vinyl-glazed pre-installed right and left window sashes from each wall panel assembly. Carefully set all of the window sashes safely off to the side for later reinstallation. Step 6. Wall panel installation. Begin the wall panel installation with the end wall that does not have the panel containing the door. Start the installation process at the existing structure and work towards the proposed front wall. Identify and locate the appropriate fill panel. Place the fill panel into the base cap expander and slide over and into the previously installed female wall channel attached to the structure. Confirm and maintain the level of the fill panel. Install the first wall panel by placing it into the base cap expander, sliding it over until the female end mullion covers the exposed end of the fill panel. Next, install the appropriate fill panel into the base cap expander, then slide over into the open wall panel end. Install the second wall panel. Using homeowner-supplied tape or a ratchet bar clamp, temporarily secure adjacent wall panel, fill panel, and wall panel sections around the window mullions to hold the pieces of the wall section together. Continue the panel installation and temporary securing process until all wall panels and fill panels are installed, thus completing one wall section. Install the corner post. Locate the appropriate front wall fill panel, and using the same installation procedures, install the front wall starting from the corner post. Secure the end wall to the front wall using the same tape procedure, combining wall and fill panels on either side of the corner post. Finish the front wall with the installation of the second corner post. Make sure to temporarily secure each wall panel prior to the start of the next wall section. Begin the installation of the remaining end wall at the second corner post. Install the appropriate fill and wall panels that do not contain the room door assembly. Next, install the appropriate fill panel closest to the structure. Locate the wall panel containing the door assembly. Remove the three hinge leaf pins and separate the door slab from the door jamb. Carefully set the door slab off to the side for later reinstallation. Place the wall panel over the top of the base cap expander and slide into its final location. Verify that the door threshold is sloping towards the exterior of the room. Install the last remaining fill panel down into place. Locate the appropriate pre-mitered base cap expander. Place the base cap expanders on the top of all the wall sections until a proper mitered corner connection is made. Install the interior and exterior fasteners to the top base cap expanders at the structure, mitered corners, and front wall seam locations only. Step 7. Hanging rail installation. Using a chalk box, draw a taut chalk line between the two exterior legs of the vertically installed female channels attached to the structure. Snap the chalk line. Measure and mark the center of the line. The roof assembly hanging rail is a two-piece system. Place the interior edge of the first piece along the vertical center line mark and atop the horizontal snapped chalk line. Rest the opposite end atop the base cap expander on the wall section. Confirming horizontal level on the hanging rail, attach the hanging rail to the structure using the approved fasteners and designated engineering spacing requirements. Repeat this process to attach the second piece on the opposite side of the center mark. Step 8. Roof panel attachment. To ensure the ease of installation, it is advised to perform a dry fit layout of all the roof assembly components at ground level prior to the start of the elevated final installation procedure. All of the roof panels come in a standard 4-foot width, with two individual long panel ends, one with a tongue profile and the other with a groove profile. The roof assembly utilizes these tongue and groove ends to help align and create a consistent thermal barrier. Each roof panel has two different short end profiles. One short end profile contains a factory cut C-fascia groove found directly underneath the exterior aluminum skin. Arrange all the roof panels to be installed with the groove profile toward the left end wall and the tongue profile towards the right end wall. Locate the roof panel with the factory removed tongue and factory cut C-fascia groove. This roof panel must be the last panel on the right side of the roof assembly. Locate the roof panel with the factory cut C-fascia groove above the groove profile. This roof panel must be installed as the last panel on the left side of the roof assembly. Make sure to lay out and align all of the roof panels with the C-fascia grooved short end on the side to be attached to the front wall. See exploded roof assembly diagrams for additional clarification to roof panel layouts. Next, count the number of roof panels in the overall roof assembly. Roof panel installation varies according to the number of roof panels in the overall assembly. Verify the total number of panels and follow the appropriate installation steps provided. If you have an odd number of roof panels, measure and lightly mark the center line on the underside of a roof panel. Lift and insert the appropriate roof panel into the hanging rail, aligning the center of the panel with the center of the hanging rail. Rest the other end of the panel on the front wall section. If you have an even number of roof panels, align the top tooth of the grooved profile of the appropriate roof panel with the interior edge of the hanging rail at the roof's center mark. Lift and insert the roof panel into the hanging rail. Rest the other end of the panel on the front wall section. Attach the roof panel to the hanging rail with the approved fasteners adhering to the installation instructions. On the right side of the secured roof panel, insert the next roof panel into the hanging rail and slide together to secure the tongue and groove connection. Insert the bottom vinyl cleat and slide into place. Attach the roof panel to the hanging rail with the approved fasteners. Repeat the process to install the remaining roof panels and bottom vinyl cleats on the right side, attaching the roof panels to the hanging rail as you go. Repeat the roof panel installation process for the left side of the roof assembly, working from the center of the roof towards the left end wall. Next, attach the roof assembly to the front wall, starting at the center line of the roof. Using a framing level, ensure the level of the front wall section. Measure the distance on the underside of the roof panel from the face of the base gap expander to the exterior face. Transfer the measurement to the top side of the roof panel. Add an additional 1 inch to the overall dimension and place a light pencil mark. Attach the roof panel to the front wall with the provided approved mechanical fastener and washer system. Use the previously determined overhang dimension and adhere to the engineering specifications required spacing to attach each roof panel. Be sure to slide the washer all the way onto the fastener and draw the fastener through the roof panel and into the front wall until the washer dimples. Continue to level the front wall while attaching each roof panel. Work your way towards either end wall. Repeat the process, attaching the roof panels, working your way towards the second end wall. Using the same leveling and measurement procedure, attach the left and right sides of the roof assembly to the corresponding end walls below. Using the approved fasteners and installation instructions, start the attachment process at the existing structure and work your way towards the front wall. With the roof assembly securely fastened to the wall sections, it is time to install the wall section's permanent mechanical fasteners. Using the provided approved fasteners and adhering to the installation instructions, install the fasteners through the base cap expanders found at the top and bottom of each wall and along all vertical wall panel mullions. Install the fasteners on both the interior and exterior of the room. Weep holes need to be produced within the base cap expander along the bottom of the exterior face of each wall section, 1 inch in from the edge of the vertical mullion. Using a half-inch chisel, punch a weep hole through the base cap expander. Step 9. Roof fascia and flashing. Starting at an outside corner, along the projection edge of the roof assembly, install the pre-mitered C-fascia. Install the C-fascia on the right and left sides, and adjust to achieve the proper mitered corner connections. Attach all sections of the C-fascia to the roof assembly, adhering to the installation instructions. Apply the sealant tape over all the roof panel seam connections. Trim and apply the sealant tape over the approved fasteners connecting the roof panels to the room below. Using a chalk box, measure, mark, and snap a chalk line for the easy trim. Apply the butyl tape to the bottom of the easy trim. Press into place along the chalk line on the roof assembly and secure with the approved fasteners, adhering to the installation instructions. If the patio room kit is being installed by way of roof mount, install and attach the pre-bent flashing with the approved fasteners, adhering to the installation instructions. Complete the flashing between the structure and the patio room kit roof assembly with homeowner-supplied upper flashing, water and ice shield, and shingles. If the patio room kit is being installed by way of a masonry wall mount, install and attach the pre-bent flashing, maintaining a 1-inch overlap, with the homeowner-supplied masonry fasteners. Use a rotary tool to scribe the structure along the masonry bed mortar line. Bend and insert the homeowner-supplied aluminum upper flashing into the masonry wall. Maintain a minimum 1-inch vertical overlap between the adjacent pieces of upper flashing. Maintain a minimum 2-inch overlap of the upper flashing on top of the supplied pre-bent flashing. Finish the upper flashing installation by applying a bead of caulk on the top of the upper flashing at its intersection with the structure. Step 10. Install sashes and screens. Position the sashes on the inside of the room, corresponding with the correct wall section. Standing inside the room, make sure to install the left sash first, followed by the right sash second. Next, slide both the sashes to the open position in the center of the window opening. Position the screens on the outside of the room, corresponding with the correct wall section. Carefully reach through the window opening and install the window screen, utilizing the screen poles into its final installed location. Lock the screen into the window jamb tracks by pushing in on the screen sash lock pins. Slide the two vinyl glazed window sashes back to their closed position. Repeat until all the sashes and screens have been installed. Step 11. Install door. Remove the dual door sweep assembly from the bottom of the door and set aside for later installation. Place the door slab into the wall panel opening, aligning the corresponding hinge leaf halves. Insert the hinge pins back into the joined hinge assembly. While maintaining a level position, secure the door jamb assembly to the adjacent fill panels using the approved fasteners and installation instructions. Place the fastener along the screw line located within the screw track of the jamb legs and header. Secure the hinge jamb first, then the striker jamb, and finally the jam header. Use a rubber mallet to carefully tap the pre-cut screw track snap caps into place, concealing all of the finished jam fasteners. Install the supplied lock set per the manufacturer's included instructions. Reinstall the dual door sweep assembly. Open and close the door. Make any adjustments necessary to the door sweeps to achieve the proper height and attach with the approved fasteners according to the installation instructions. Thank you. This completes the patio room kit installation steps. We hope you found this information helpful, and we know you are going to enjoy your patio room for years to come.